pop, okay? This is my pop. Okay. Okay, the first time you run the cell load simulation and so on, you have this the simulation displayed on the cell, but it doesn't run and give you an error, but it's not a problem because it's just to display the same file. Don't run the Docker now, so comment it and then run. So I add the SkyView factor. So I add another version of them. The one is the one that you are working on, and the other one is the same but with lower resolution. So if you run the SkyView factor or Cringing Raster on this file, it's faster. So this is the SkyView factor on the low resolution raster. The same on the one with full resolution. Okay. Everybody of you can display this file.
What we can tell was the evaporation because mine seems corrupted.
Okay.
I don't know why.
Yeah, I'm sorry. In OSF, camera 14, in OSF stored under the presentation of today. Okay. So, if you are able to run and display this image, put the yellow sticky note. Don't run the simulation because all the files are already in your folder. So just run the command. Okay. Comment the Docker cell. Okay. Can I move on? Okay, the second notebook is the one on shortwave. Okay. Do the same for this one. Okay, in this case I add also the image to your folder so you are able to display it. Update as before the path and don't run the Docker command. Okay. nobody of you has a problem with the shortwave appointees. Can you display it? When you are here, put the yellow sticking on. Correct for index is a lot. If you don't have a clear additional argument, you can use the one simulated, so the free potential simulation. And at the end,
in this case, you have more realistic.
Yeah, more realistic representation. Otherwise, you can. You can calibrate at the end all the stuff together. Okay? Okay. Then the shortwave raster. Import the raster IO. This is the stem with lower resolution. Okay, is the same of is the sorry the dam of the emulator and notch, but with lower resolution. This is the raster file of precipitation, temperature, interpolated with the region raster. Okay. Comment this cell. And this is the shortwave raster. See that the lower radiation is on the north face of the mountain, obviously. Okay, for everybody. Okay. So this finish. Open the one on the long wave radiation. Before run everything, update the path. Okay. Here the table and the parameter of each model. This one and run everything.
This shortwave radiation is just for a specific hour or is for a day?
Is
average over each 10 years.
It's not average. Is the shortwave on the whole period? Our period is from 2010 to 2014, and this is the potential shock with radiation because
it doesn't. It's average? No.
No.
Right. Over which time period?
4 years.
More period? From
it's an average over 4 years. One day? When? Which time?
But the raster one, is 1 hour. No, it's 1 hour.
Yeah, specific time.
It's a specific time. That is how much.
Okay, yeah, the raster one is just one time step. This one is the whole period. Okay, not in this case is just 1 year, probably. page. This is the difference between the two long wave tradition of the component downwelling, not the upwelling, okay? Okay, so display also the result for the long wave raster. Then temperature, scale factor, and this is upwelling long wave radiation raster with the model number 6. Okay. And the same for sorry. It's not the model number 6. Here I changed the cloud parameter, sorry. In the first map, 0.4 and 0.8, and in the second map are 0 and 1 again. Okay? So it's very different. And the downwelling is always the same. Okay? It doesn't change with the change of parameter or with the model.
Okay. I can show one of the maps.
Okay.
One before. It's just before the long wave raster.
Long wave raster.
At the beginning.
Okay. last one on that radiation. The path, the name, and this is the net radiation, so the incoming shortwave minus the upwelling long wave plus the downwelling long wave. Okay. Okay. The yellow sticky note. Lidia asked me, okay, this is not the upwelling radiation, this is the downwelling, and the one below obviously is the upwelling. So the upwelling depends on the soil temperature. Okay, so it's not affected by the atmosphere. So if we change the model or the ground parameter, what is changing is the downwelling. So the component of the long wave radiation coming from the atmosphere. Okay, so update the title. Also the name is downwelling, only the title was wrong. Case, but the 7 are the number of sensoric. Okay.
The so center of each subphasing.
Yeah. Because maybe I get a picture.
Okay, and the peaks are related to problems in input data or what?
probably. Okay. So this is the Meleagro. So Meleagro and which is the name of this
upper noce catchment.
Okay, upper this is the upper noce because the Meleagro is only
is
the
this is the
seven. So all the results we show are on the upper noce, easy. And the CSV result, so the data frames, are seven columns because we have one for each centroid. Okay? It's okay for everybody. Okay, so open the evapotranspiration notebook. So if you can't open it, download from the OSFP.
We don't have the access of the exercise.
But it is in the presentation.
Yes.
Something about the evaporation theory.
Okay.
The primary thing found in the formula we use this case is the potential of evaporation in this case, or is it a generic? Because I don't found something consistent about the resistance.
No, because in Pao, the resistance are essentially parameterized, so you can.
And it's related to low atmosphere turbulence.
So.
Oh.
Okay. We take the power equation from the power page. So there is all about the time-mounted and the time-mounted PAU version. So if you are interested in the theory, you can. Okay.
Thanks a lot. Thank you.
No, don't worry. You are welcome. Okay. So at the link that is the documentation for the evapotranspiration. Actually, in GeoFrame image, there are three different evapotranspiration: the Penman Montit, Priestley Taylor, and the one of Szymanski and Dor. Actually, the documentation that is only for the Penman Montit for the Fowl equation. The Priestley Taylor also, but not for the last one. Okay, here's some theory that Riccardo showed you before. So, in this case, the simulation are really fast because there are no parameters. So the only thing you have to do is print the data and run the model. The input for the Pau equation are net radiation, average wind speed, relative humidity, and sorry for so the alpha obviously is not an input for the power equation because it is the alpha of Priestley Taylor. So import the library as usual. Set the path. Okay. So I'm sorry if there is some error, but I did it yesterday evening, so I was a little bit hard. So the first simulation we'll run is the Priestley Taylor. So this is the structure of the simulation. You have the start and end date as usual. The input parameter, temperature, high temperature, net radiation, pressure. Okay. Then we have some parameter. One is the default pressure. Another one is the alpha of Priestley Taylor, the one I did before. And then this two coefficients that we use to parameterize the solid flux using this relation, okay? Okay, so the half of Priestley Taylor was from 0.7, I guess, until 4 or something like this. So you can change this parameter inside this range if you want. 1.26 is the mean value. Okay. So run the simulation. I'm using Docker. If you use the console, Docker, what you want.
So in this case, it is assumed that we have measurements of relative humidity, right, and wind speed somewhere.
Yeah, and we have it. I have the relative humidity and the wind to your folder, so you can find this. In output region, here you have precipitation, relative humidity, air temperature, and wind interpolated on the centroids. Even if interpolate wind and relative humidity is not.
So we just have the cringe of data, right? Not the original ones.
Yeah. get the pressure from the station, but the station are outside the basin, so I can't use it. Okay, this are the same operation as usual. Okay. During the night, the evapotranspiration is zero. So it's not an error. Okay. And this is the plot for the evapotranspiration of this detailer in the fourth year. Okay?
This is for one centroid, for example.
Yeah.
And another six.
And
the limits are millimeter, day,
millimeter hour. Okay. So the second simulation is the thermal mounting. In this case, the output are temperature, wind, relative humidity. Okay, net radiation, atmospheric pressure.
Been already calculated, or and are basically you saved all those time series for each centroid.
Yeah. So
so here the model just reads such time series.
Yeah, because on Friday we do the bridging.
And you calculated all the inputs.
We calculated the temperature and so on. Then yesterday the radiation. Then today I let's say rearrange the folder. I insert all the input that you need for run the evapotranspiration. Okay. And another input is the soil flux, if you have this kind of measurement, otherwise you can comment it, okay? The output, the connection as usual, so run the simulation if you want. Okay. And then the result. In this case, the evapotranspiration during the night for the 10-month PAL is not zero. Okay. Can you run it? Somebody has some problem. Okay. Does it work for everybody? Okay, perfect. Okay. The last one is the component based on the Szymanski-Lohr formula. Actually, there is no documentation, so you have to provide soon. Here there is the paper about the Szymanski-Lohr formula. Okay, as Ricardo said before, when we have vegetation, we have transpiration. Otherwise, if there is no vegetation, it's only evaporation. So this component compute only the transpiration, okay? So the evaporation, sorry, is my vector. Okay. In this model, there are a lot of input. High temperature, relative humidity, wind velocity, short wave, both a direct component and a diffuse one. The long wave radiation, in this case, only the downwelling component. The atmospheric pressure, the leaf area index, okay? The stress factor, the soil flux, centroid dam as usual, and the soil water content. So actually, soil flux and the soil water content are neglected, okay? Because in general, I don't have this kind of measurement. The stress factor is a time series, like the air temperature and so on. And in this case is a time series equal to 1.
And 1 means there's no stress.
Yeah. Because as Ricardo told you before, we are essentially computing the potential of transpiration, but the transpiration is let's say governed by the stress factor. Okay, so if there is enough water, enough radiation, the evapotranspiration, in this case the transpiration, is smaller. Okay? So actually, I insert the stress factor equal to 1, so we are talking about potential evapotranspiration. Okay? And there is also a parameter. The parameter is the type of canopy. In this case, you can use a different surface, for example, a flat surface, so the transpiring area is equal to 1. Okay? If you set the grassland, the transpiring area is equal to the leaf area index. And if you use the multi-layer canopy model, the transpiring area surface is equal to a multi-layer canopy model, so essentially is a tree, a canopy. With some, sorry?
That is contained in the component.
Yeah. And in this case, okay, I have, okay, this is a simple example of a multi-layer canopy model. when we are using a multi-layer canopy model, we have a fraction of canopy in sunlight, another fraction in the shadow. So we have and sun, that is the latent heat by the fraction of canopy in sunlight, and yeah, shadow is the one emitted by the canopy in shadow. So the structure of the scene file is the same. Okay, you can comment or uncomment one of these, depends on you, which model do you like, if a flat surface, grassland, or multi-layer canopy model. If you change, do full print with false, it will print only the latent heat and the water transpire, otherwise we'll print all the output. All the output are this, sorry, the latent heat emitted by the canopy, both the shadow shaded part and the sunlight part, the sensible heat, the least temperature, the total transpiration, obviously, the fraction of canopy in sunlight, and the total shortwave radiation absorbed by the canopy. Okay. Okay. Except this parameter, all the other components are readers, so you can use the data in the folder. So please try to run it. Okay. So let's open the result. In this case, as I told before, as I said before, sorry, with Christian, this is a method based on the energy budget, so it's physical based, and in this case we have transpiration also during the night because we didn't include the stress factor. So we include a stress factor equal to 1, okay? So this is the reason we have no transpiration, sorry, during the night. Okay, the second variation as before. This is the result. So we have the maximum of the summer. And okay, now you can compare the pre evapotranspiration control number 6. Okay. Just for 1 month in July. And this is the result.
You can see so.
I have to check because
seems to be different units or something like that.
No, it's probably
how
due
be?
To the net radiation. The net radiation is very low, but I have to check because it looks strange.
Something with the data or something wrong in the component?
I have to check because I usually don't use the Penman file, so it's not a main component. So I have to check because it's too low. So more or less this is everything about transpiration, so my suggestion is try to run the component, changing the parameter, for example the alpha parameter of the Priestley-Taylor, or try different canopy model for optimal indoor component as you want, and then display the result with some statistic. Okay. So more or less, so if you need help